day, my name's Claire Hayes and I have a DBED in primary teaching and infants teaching in New South Wales. Well, of course, we have to teach Australian history. But my passion for Australian history was really awakened at the Rocks area in Sydney, where thousands of international visitors used to come in to hear British traditional music played. From there I went to Old Sydney Town, which is a village of a recreation of Sydney between 1788 and 1810. There we were issued a name of a first fleeter. Mine was Mrs. Barnsley and I was the midwife. I had great fun with that. In the town, there were all the animals of the town, merchandising. We were all given costume that we wore, of course. And the music that we played there was British traditional music. So I was paid for 6 hours a day to sing music that I was already working with. I thought I'd died and gone to heaven. We could take our kids, we could take our dogs, and the whole place was alive. It was like a living museum. So the food was authentic, the schoolhouse was authentic, and all the merchandise was as authentic as we could get it. So in amongst all that, we talk about the first fleeters, the women, the children, the music, and my series of 10 talks cover those topics. From there I went up about 4 or 5 hours north of Gosford and went to a place called Timbertown. And Timbertown was a village of the 1900s, so we sang music that belonged to the bush era. So that was about drovers and shearers and swaggies and bullockies. And there, steam had been invented by then, so we had a little steam train that ran around the outside of the village, and the actual timber mill was run by steam. We had a bullocky, and there was a lot of emphasis on, of course, loading the timber and yoking up the bullocks. There was a penny farthing racing around town, and I rode a bicycle. But my main job was to sing in the tavern. And of course, there's so many stories within the music. And that's what my talks are about. And I use a slideshow with photos from both of those villages, as well as internet photographs that I've researched.